Hey fam, this is your fabulous prophet Barry. I thank God for today. I thank you for waking me up this morning in my right mind and giving me the mobility of my limbs. Amen. I just wanted to chat with you all just for a few minutes this morning. Let me turn this music down. I just wanted to chat with you a little bit. Well, I guess it would be afternoon now. But anyways, when I woke up this morning, the Lord led me to come to a specific church. And I obeyed the Lord and I got here. And I know when God does that, He has something for me. He has a word for me. Amen. And I received that word today. God gave me some instructions for some things that I must do in order for Him to relaunch or rebrand Free Spirit Ministry International. Amen. So that's my main focus right now. At least I'm trying to make that my main focus. However, with the cares of the world and situations and circumstances in life, you know, we sometimes get deterred. We sometimes get off course and lose focus. Amen. But I know that the Lord has called me into ministry. He called me into ministry back in 2013. And one thing I know is this. When God calls you, when He chooses you, you don't have no choice in the matter but to do what God says to do. Amen. And being a prophet of God that He called me to be, I tell y'all what, it has not been an easy task. Excuse me. It has not been easy, but I tell you what, it sure has been worth it. It has been worth it because I know God has greater things in store for me, not just me, but for the lost souls, for people that are out there that are unchurched and you just don't have any place to go or don't feel comfortable going any place. But that being said, you know, it has become difficult, you know, for me to, you know, to kind of get in a place and stay put, because what I see, when I see that the lost is still lost, you know, and they're out there and they're struggling and they got all these issues and things going on, it's kind of hard for me to just sit in that one place and just ignore what's happening around me. Amen. So my heart is definitely for the lost, those that are out there in the street, those that are, you know, on drugs or gambling or gang members, people that are unchurched, people who don't feel like they're loved by the church. That's who God has called me to minister to. And many of you know that I've been doing it for years, right? Just kind of out on the street. But now God is launching the ministry, and I have to embrace it. I have to embrace it. And I also want to address today, while I'm on here, the Lord was talking to me yesterday about truth. You know, about truth and about people telling the truth. I don't know what this is. Let me turn that down. Speaking to me about truth, you know, about truth. And one thing, anybody who knows me, y'all know I walk in the truth. And there's no shame in my game. I have to be honest and I have to tell the truth. I want y'all to know something. The happiness that you've been seeing in me, all of that joy and that happiness that you've been seeing with me and Mr. Barry, let me tell y'all something. That is the joy of the Lord that is on the inside of me. That is the happiness that has came for me, from me focusing on me. From me taking the time to focus on me. From me taking the time to spend time with me and do things with me and for me. Amen. So a lot of people wait for their spouses to make them happy, or they look for their friends or whomever to make them happy. I did that some years ago, but last year I made up my mind that I was never going to depend on a human being. Whether it be husband, wife, sister, brother, children, family, friends, whoever. I made up my mind last year that I was not going to let people dictate my happiness. Amen. And so, as I say this to you, this lady looks like she's about to hit my car. Well, I guess she got it. But I say this to you because I want people to understand the joy that I have, it has nothing to do with Mr. Barry. The peace that I have, it has nothing to do with Mr. Barry. This happiness that y'all see, it has nothing to do with Mr. Barry. And I want y'all to understand that, because so many people depend on others to make them happy. You can make yourself happy. Do what you desire to do. Do things, check out your own life. If you see things in your own life that's out of order, things that's hindering you, things that are causing you to be bound, work on those things. Work on those things so that joy can come, happiness can come. Another person, if your happiness is dependent on another person, you're in trouble. Let me say that again. If your happiness is if you're dependent on happiness from someone else, you are in trouble. And I promise you that. I promise you, you're going to be in trouble. because people will trick you, people will fool you, people will lie to you, and they will dishonor you, and they will disrespect you, and next thing you know, you're sad and you're looking miserable. But I just want to say to some of the married couples out there today, you know, some of you may have a husband that's out of control. You know, some of you may have a husband that's a compulsive gambler or drug user. You may have one that's a workaholic or an alcoholic. You may have one that has an issue with multiple women. Whatever that issue may be, ladies, I just want to say this to you. Get your focus off of them, because I made that mistake early on in my marriage, that I was so focused on Mr. Berry that I lost who I was. Come on, somebody. I lost who I was. But I tell you what, my daughter used to always tell me, Mama, focus on you, focus on you, focus on you. And I promise you, I took heed to what my daughter was saying to me, and I began to focus on me. And this is why you guys are seeing me blossom. This is why you're seeing, and people ask me, they tell me, Prophet, you're so pretty. You look so good. What are you doing? You look young. You know, that's because I decided to shake all of that weight off of me. All of that worryation about my spouse. All of that worryation about my kids, my family and friends and all those folks. I shook that worryation off. And so I say to you today, wives, if you're struggling, if you're dealing with a worldly man, I made a post yesterday when my husband and I were riding out, okay? Like I said, that happiness that y'all see has nothing to do with Mr. Berry. Come on, somebody. It has nothing to do with Mr. Berry. That is the happiness that I acquired because I chose to work on me. I chose to take myself to therapy, take myself to counseling, and sit down and deal with my own issues and my own problems. Come on. And that's what I'm saying to you wives today. Because some of these husbands, they're never going to change. Some of them, they're going to be on drugs till Jesus come. They're going to be in the gambling house till Jesus come. They're going to be dealing with multiple women till Jesus come. They're going to be on alcohol till Jesus come. Come on. They're going to be disrespecting you till Jesus come. So a lot of these men are never going to change. They're never going to change. So I'm saying to you, you do not have to stay in that. You don't have to stay bound by that. Amen. I talk about a godly wife and a worldly husband because this is the situation that I'm in currently, right? But I'm going to tell you something. God told us in the word that the sanctified wife will sanctify the unsaved husband. That's what the word of God said, and vice versa. But he also said it's not guaranteed that that spouse will change. It's not guaranteed that they will conform or convert or transition into being who God called them to be. Now, ladies, if you know that you've done all you can do, and you've put in all the work that you can put in with your spouse, and I'm not talking about just with him, but have you worked on you? Have you dug deep down inside to see what's inside of you that may cause you to not be able to love that man unconditionally? Ladies, I'm talking to you today. Wives, I'm talking to you today. Amen. Don't be lying and pretending you're happy and acting like you're happy in public, but you're going through per hell behind closed doors. Y'all know I'm the first one to tell the story. It ain't been easy dealing with Mr. Berry at all, okay? Mr. Berry is not where I would like for him to be still. But like I told y'all, the happiness that you see, it is from the Lord, and it's from me putting in the work. And I am determined that come hell or high water, it don't make no difference with me what. Whatever it's going to take for me to maintain my happiness, whatever it's going to take for me to maintain my peace and my joy that the Lord has given me, then, hey, that's what I'm going to do. If I got to get rid of some people, bam, that's what I'm going to do. If the husband got to go, bam, that's what's going to have to happen. But I refuse. Come on, somebody. I refuse to be hindered by somebody who don't want change. So ladies, if you're out there and you got a husband and you're saved and you're trying to serve God the best of your ability and your husband just don't want change, he don't want to do what God called him to do, listen, the Bible says separate yourself. He says separate yourself because he wants us to do whatever can serve him best. That's what he said in his word. He said, if you cannot get along, separate yourself. That's what the word of God said. He said, because he wants us to do whatever it takes to serve him best. And I'm telling y'all, I'm getting ready to launch out into ministry. So anybody and anything that is not lining up with what God has for me to do in my life, I'm going to X you out. I'm getting ready to cut you completely off because the time has come for ministry to go forth. Amen. So wives out there, ladies, if you're single, if you are meeting a man or you've met a man and this man is disrespecting you, he's dishonoring you. You know, he don't want to provide for you. He don't want to, you know, do what's supposed to be done to love you. Let me tell you something. Run for your life. Run. And I say this from my own experience. Yes, I wrote the book, Can the a Godly Wife and the Worldly Husband, Can the Marriage Work? I wrote that book because God told me to write that book. Now, what the end gonna be, I don't know. You know, like I said, the happiness that y'all see, that's because God has done a work in my life. And I have been able to get rid of a lot of things that was tormenting me from my past that I brought into my marriage. But now that I've worked out those things and I'm working through those things, and anything, like I say, anything that God has for you to do, it's going to be hard to do it dragging a dead man around in a body bag. And that's what I like to say to women. If you're married to a man that's worldly and he don't want to put in the work, he don't want to change, he don't want to come out of the street, he don't want to, you know, respect you and love you, it's like dragging around a dead man in a body bag. Come on, somebody. Oh, ask me how I know. So I'm saying to you today to encourage you, you don't have to be stuck in that mess. You don't have to be bound. You don't have to continue on. If you've been married 10 years, 5 years, 15, 20 years, you do not have to settle. You do not have to settle for just being in that pain because the church said you don't supposed to divorce. That's what the church said. But God said, hey, if you're not getting along, separate yourself. Separate. If you don't want to divorce, you don't have to divorce. But separate yourself if your spouse is hindering you from carrying out your full potential and what God called you to do. Come on, somebody. I'm talking to somebody today because there's a lot of wives that's married to preachers and vice versa that's going through hell behind these closed doors. But they put on a straight face for the church, for the people. But what about your peace? What about your joy? What about your sanity? What about you? What about you for a change, ladies? Come on, you don't have to settle for that stuff that's going on behind those doors. Come on, talk about it. Put it in a book like I did. I'm working on a second book. A Godly Wife and a Worldly Husband, Can the Marriage Work? Part 2. Amen. I have not been able to really answer that question yet because things that's going on in my life, it's not lining up with what I know God said must be. Amen. So I can't say whether or not it worked. I do know one thing is hell, is problems, is trouble being married to a worldly man, especially if they are not putting in the work. Amen. But it's not just a worldly man that's acting a fool. You got a lot of saved men. Come on, somebody. You got a lot of saved men out there that's mistreating their wives, that's mistreating their mates. A lot of saved people. So I'm addressing everybody today simply because this is what God put on my heart today to minister. Listen, do whatever you have to do to get your peace. Do whatever you have to do to restore your joy. Do whatever you have to do. Come on, somebody. Do whatever you have to do to be happy. Remember, people are not responsible for making you happy. That is your own responsibility. So you do what you have to do to bring happiness, peace, and joy in your own life. Amen. And I promise you, when you get that joy, when you get that happiness and that peace, nobody can take it from you. And that is a word to the people of God today from the prophet. I thank you for listening, and I praise God for each and every one of you. And God bless. And I will be chatting with you all soon. But again, I just wanted to put this word out there for some people to know and understand. You don't have to be bound by the hands of the enemy. If your spouse, your friends, your loved ones, whomever, your children, whoever is in your life is causing you trouble and causing problems and causing you to be hindered from carrying out the full mission and plan of God, then you need to make a change. You need to do something about it. Amen. God bless you all.